So when it comes to carbonic maceration, it's essentially something that's a fairly modern style, right? Because in order to do full carbonic maceration, you have to have a stainless steel tank and you have to have the ability to flush that completely with inert gas. Of course, CO2 is most widely used for this, because for carbonic maceration, you put in the whole bunches, 100% whole bunches, and then in the lack of oxygen, yeast cannot start fermenting, even if there's a little juice there. So what happens is essentially an enzymatic change inside of the berry that starts breaking down the sugar into alcohol, but then also a little bit of gas is produced. So then the berry starts bursting open because of this. Again, this is an enzymatic driven reaction. It's not a fermentation, okay? Even though sugar turns into alcohol. But then once that berry bursts open, you're starting to have juice that is available for the yeast to start fermenting, and especially if it starts being macerated and moved around and the CO2 is allowed to escape, then proper alcohol fermentation can begin. And you wanna have it begin as well, because when it comes to the enzyme-driven reaction, you can only get up to about 2% alcohol, which obviously is not sufficient for winemaking. So you have to have the yeast finish up the job, pick it up from there. So once the berry starts bursting open, they start cap maceration techniques, either punch down or pump over to introduce some oxygen and allow the yeast to start the fermentation.